Okay, so we'll start off with properties of triangles, and this is basically the theory that was there in S.L. Loney plane trigonometry. It is in chapter 12 and chapter 15 in S.L. Loney. So we'll quickly discuss the theory and see if we are able to prove the results here. So the first thing that you want to understand is what is sine rule and cosine rule? Sine rule and cosine rule in triangles. These two results are true for any triangle, and we want to understand what is sine rule and cosine rule. So in general, if you have a triangle like this, what the way we label it is A, B, C vertices, and opposite the vertices we have sides small a, small b, and small c. And this angle is A, basically this angle is B, this angle is C. These are side lengths. And if I want to talk about sine rule, I will have to draw a circumcircle that passes through the vertices A, B, and C. So some circle like this will be needed, and the radius of this circle would be equal to capital R. Capital R stands for circum radius, which is basically the radius of the circumcircle of the triangle. So in this, if you have seen the sine rule before, you know how the circumcircle is constructed. How is the circumcircle constructed? Does anyone know? How do you construct the circumcircle of a triangle?
Perpendicular bisectors and will their intersection is the center.
Yeah, so if you
Drawing the perpendicular bisector and the intersection will be the circumcircle.
draw perpendicular bisectors, basically what that means is take BC side and take the midpoint of BC side and draw a perpendicular there. And similarly, this is 90 and this is midpoint. Similarly, midpoint here, draw a perpendicular here. And again, this is 90 and these are midpoints. So these two perpendicular bisectors, you can draw the third one also, but two of them will intersect at a point. And the third one will also pass through that point. This point is known as the circumcenter. Why is this the circumcenter? That's everyone knows, okay, how it is constructed, but why is this correct? Why is the intersection point going to be circumcenter?
Because the distance of any vertex from that point will be same for all the three vertices.
How do you know that? How do you prove that?
We can measure that.
Measuring is
What's the
not a
property of
proof.
a circle that whenever you draw a perpendicular bisector from a chord in a circle, it always passes through the center?
Okay, so you're saying these are two chords of the circle.
Yes, sir.
AB and BC are two chords of the circle, and therefore the perpendicular from their midpoint will always pass through the center, and the circle has only one center. Therefore, that center point is going to be the perfect circumcenter, right? Or you can say easily that if I join this and this, you will have this triangle and this triangle are congruent by SAS. This is equal, it is given to this because midpoint, and this is a common side, and angle between them is also same, right? So we can say very easily that this triangle dot is congruent to this triangle, which means if you call this point O, OB is equal to OC, right? And in a similar way, I can join this A and again prove that this triangle and this triangle are congruent by SAS. Therefore, OA will be equal to OB. So finally, combining these two, you get OA is equal to OB is equal to OC, right? So O is the point that is equidistant from all the three vertices, and that point is the center of the circumcircle or the circumcenter. So we know now that, okay, circumcircle can be constructed by a drawing perpendicular bisectors. And now what we do is basically prove sine rule. So if you have a situation like this, let's say we have a circumcircle. This is my circumcircle. Let's say we drew one perpendicular bisector like this and another perpendicular bisector like this. So this point is my circumcenter and this is A, B, C. I want to join this and like this. So let's call this point D. I have a triangle OBD. Can someone tell me angle BOD will be how much? This angle.
It would be equal to A.
Why will it be equal to A? That is correct. Why?
Because angle BOC is twice of angle A, and triangle BOD and triangle COD are congruent. So,
yeah. So, angle BOC is twice of angle this because this is the center and this is angle on the circumference and this is angle on the center by the same chord. So, we know that the inscribed angle will be half of the angle at the center, right? So, therefore, if this is A, this is 2A, and this triangle are congruent. So we get this angle, angle BOD is coming out to be simply A. Everyone understands this, right? Why?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So if this angle is coming out to be A, we know that this is 90 degree. And we know that the base, total base side was given as small a. Therefore, this is A by 2, right? BD. BD is A by 2. And now in triangle OBD, what we can say is sine of angle BOD is equal to perpendicular by hypotenuse. So this is BD by OB. So this is becoming BD by OB. And this is sine of angle A is equal to BD by OB. BD is A by 2 and OB is capital R, right? OB is capital R, circumradius. So therefore, you get A by 2R is equal to sine A. And we get the result A by sine A is equal to 2 capital R, right? Correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Similarly, you can get a similar result here also. And this time you will get C by 2 here. And this angle will be C. So you'll get C by sine A, sine C is equal to 2 capital R. Exactly same method. And finally, you can say that A by sine A is equal to B by sine B is equal to C by sine C is equal to 2 capital R. This is your final result that comes from sine rule. Basically, it says that in any triangle, the side opposite to any angle, if you take A by the sine of that angle opposite to it, A by sine A and B by sine B and C by sine C, that is always equal to a constant, and that constant is equal to diameter of the circumcircle, right? Now, we will see how this result is going to be super useful to us as we do more and more problems. For now, this is sine rule and this is the way it is proved. I hope everyone has understood this much.
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. Sir.
Yes, sir.
Then cosine rule. The class is being recorded, so all of these will be shared with you on the website. So you can see the course, the video later if you have any doubt about anything. So I'm not going to repeat too much. And if someone has joined late, then you can watch it later if you have missed something. Cosine rule is A, B, C. And now in this case, we draw a perpendicular from A to the side BC. This is D, AD, right? And we call this total side is called small a, this total side is called small c, and this is called small b, right? Now, in cosine rule, this is a 90 degree that has been dropped by construction. So can someone tell me how we can write this length BD? Can someone say, tell me anything about BD? What will be BD? Remember that
cos b element of b square minus a square
cos.
No, that's under root of c square minus ad square. No, it is not under root of b square minus a square. Oh, what are you saying? Someone was saying something like that. What we can say is simply c cos b. That is correct.
Yes.
Because cos b, this is a right angle triangle. Cos b will be bd by AB, which is BD by C. So C cos B will be BD, right? If this much is C cos B, then CD will be what? CD will be A minus C cos B, right? A minus C cos B, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Because total thing was A and this is C cos B. So, great. And what is AD? AD is equal to C sine B. Everyone can see that, I think. AD is C sine B, same triangle. So this is C sine B. Now we have another right angle triangle. We have right angle triangle ADC, in which one side is C sine B, one side is A minus C cos B, and one side is B. So by Pythagoras theorem, you can say that B square should be equal to C sine B whole square plus A minus C cos B whole square, right? This is Pythagoras theorem on triangle ACD. And from here you will get B square is equal to C square sine square B plus A square plus C square cos square B minus 2AC cos B, right? So now you will write D square and combine C square cos square and C square sine square. So you will get C square plus A square minus 2AC cos B, right? Correct.
Yes, sir.
So now finally, yes, you will solve for cos B and you will say cos B is equal to C square plus A square minus B square by 2AC. And this is your formula for cosine rule. And right now we have proven it for one particular thing. You can also do cosine rule if you dropped an altitude like this. You could have done it in this place, same thing. Or you could have dropped an altitude like this and done it here. So eventually you will get three formulas here. Cos B is this. Cos A will be equal to B square plus C square minus A square by 2BC. And finally, cos C will be A square plus B square minus C square by 2AB. So all these three formulas stand for your cosine rule in a triangle. And remember the pattern here. It is easy to remember the formula by a pattern. You can say that, okay, this is my triangle A, B, C. And if I want to find cosine rule for cos B, first I will label the sides. This is C, this is A, this is B. Then cos B is going to be this square plus this square minus this square by 2 into AC. So C square plus A square minus B square by 2AC. And basically, when you form the cos, the angles that form, the lines that form the cos, those squares are added and the opposite side is subtracted. So if I have to write cos A is formed by this and this. So it should be equal to B square plus C square and subtraction of opposite square minus A square by 2BC. Is everyone following the pattern?
Yes.
Yes, sir. So this is cosine rule, and sine rule is obviously A by sine A is equal to B by sine B is equal to C by sine C is equal to 2R. So this is your sine rule. The reason we have done cosine rule and sine rule in the beginning is because from here we can derive a lot of triangle properties, which will be simple. If you know a little bit of trigonometry, then you can just keep deriving many of the triangle properties. So this is basically the important idea in the chapter number 12. From here, now you can prove many things. For example, suppose you have a question like this. In any triangle, prove that b square minus c square cot A plus c square minus a square cot B plus a square minus b square cot C is equal to 0. So this is one question. You can also get a question like this. Prove that prove that A plus B by A minus B is equal to tan A plus B by 2 cot A minus B by 2. Again, this is true in any triangle ABC. You can solve questions like this one. The sides of a right angle triangle are 21 and 28. Find the length of the perpendiculars. Drawn to the hypotenuse from the right angle. So what I want you guys to do is solve the first three questions. These questions, again, you will be able to solve by sine and cosine rules. Okay, so try these three questions. You have 5 minutes time. Okay, 5 minutes. You will should be able to do these in that much time. So I will just give you 5 minutes. 5 minutes later, we'll discuss the solutions to this and then we'll proceed further. Okay, so first question, anybody has any ideas?
Converting cot into cos A by sin A.
Cot A will be cos A by sin A, and therefore if you
and
write
applying cosine rule on cos A.
Cosine rule, if you do on cos A, then what will come? B square plus C square minus A square will come on top by 2BC, right?
Yes, sir.
And sin A, you will apply sin rule, right?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So I will just rub off the first question here and I will say what comes here. So you'll get B square minus C square into B square plus C square minus A square by 2BC into sin A can be written as 2R into A by sin A is 2R. So 2R by, one second, I'll just write it here. Sin A, I want. So A by sin A is equal to 2R. So sin A is therefore A by 2R, right? So now you would get this expression becomes B square minus C square multiplied by B square plus C square minus A square by 2BC, and instead of sin A, we'll write A by 2R, right? So you will notice that all the three denominators become 2ABC, right? Correct?
Yes.
In all three terms, denominator will become same. It will be 2ABC, and we can take that out common. You can take 2R also common. You just have to add these types of expressions. Right? Correct. There will be three such expressions. You'll get 2R by ABC, and you have to add this part plus B square minus C square into B square plus C square minus A square plus another expression would be C square minus A square into C square plus A square minus B square, and another expression will be A square minus B square into A square plus B square minus C square, right?
Yes.
Something like this should come because there are three terms, right? And same thing you are doing. Every time you are replacing cot A by cos A by sin A and putting cos rule for cos A and sin rule for sin A, right?
Yes.
So now you can easily see that this is becoming B power 4 minus C power 4. And this is C power 4 minus A power 4 and A power 4 minus B power 4, which all add up to 0. And finally, you also have A square into B square minus C square plus C square minus A square into B square plus C square into A square minus B square. That also, when you simplify, it will add up to 0. So the whole thing will cancel. The sum of three terms will become 0, this whole thing. Okay. You can do it yourself. It is obvious. So you just needed to apply cos rule and sin rule here. Let's look at the second one. In second one, what will we do?
We can write A as 2R sin A and B as 2R sin B on LHS.
Yeah.
And we can use formula for sin C plus sin D.
Correct. So you need to know a little bit of trigonometry for second one because you need to know the basic formula for what is sin C minus sin D, sin C plus sin D. Okay. So this formula you need to know, sin C plus sin D. If you don't know this, then there are simple, there are proofs for these formulas on my YouTube channel. Like there are videos on basic trigonometry, sum of angles and stuff. So you can just look at that if you are not aware of the formula. If you are aware of the formula, good. Then you know that sin C minus sin D is equal to 2 sin C minus D by 2 cos C plus D by 2, right? And sin C plus sin D will be equal to 2 sin C plus D by 2 cos C minus D by 2, correct?
Yes, sir.
So yes. Now what we are doing here is we are first realizing that this side was a relationship in the terms of the sides, right? Small a and small b are sides, and this side there is angle, right? So many times in solving identities based on properties of triangles, you will realize that some relationship in terms of sides has to be proven to be equal to something else in terms of angles, right? So in that, the standard thing to do is to convert any of the two sides into the other. So basically what we are doing is applying sine rule here and writing it as 2r sine a plus 2r sine b by 2r sine a minus 2r sine b. And 2r, 2r will cancel everywhere. 2r cancels throughout and you end up having just sine a minus sine b by sine a plus sine b, right? And as soon as you use the formula there, this is sine a minus sine b by sine a plus sine b. As soon as now you use the formula, it becomes this side because you get 2 sine a minus b by 2 cos a.
The numerator plus.
Oh, huh. Numerator is plus and denominator is minus. So you'll get plus here and minus here divided by 2 sine a minus b by 2 by cos a plus b by 2. 2, 2 cancels. This sine a plus b by 2 and cos a plus b by 2 become your tan. And this sine a minus b by 2 by cos a minus a by 2 becomes a tan again, but in the denominator. So you get tan a plus b by 2 divided by tan a minus b by 2, which is the solution, which is the proof, because this is caught, right? Correct?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
For this question, what will you do? This is a right angle triangle. Two sides are given. Sides of the right angle are given. So this is 21 and this is 28.
Hypotenuse.
Hypotenuse will be 35, right? Because
yes.
This is 7 into
yes, 3 sir.
And this is 7 into 4. So this should be 7 into 5, right?
Yes.
35. You have to find the length of the perpendicular drawn from the hypotenuse, drawn to the hypotenuse from the right angle, right? Okay, so the first thing that we know here, okay, I'll do it on the next screen. So suppose this is the situation. This is 21, this is 28, this is 35. And we want to find out this length, right? So we want to find out this X unknown length, correct? So if we say A, B, C, then immediately we can say that sine C is known, or actually angle is known, because we can say sine C is equal to 21 by 35. So 3 by 5, right? And what is this? This is sine A is equal to 28 by 35, which is 4 by 5, correct? These things we directly know. Now, if we have to do this, what I need is basically doing triangle BDC. In triangle BDC, I can do sine rule, right? Sine rule. Sine rule says that X by sine C will be equal to 28 by sine of this, right? Sine of 90 degree, which is 1, correct? Is everyone understanding this statement?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Angle BDC, we are doing sine rule. Sine rule says that A by sine A is B by sine B. And we just have X here and sine C here, and this side by sine 90. So I'm just writing A by sine A is equal to this. And from here, I get X is equal to 28. Sine 90 is 1 and 28 sine C. And sine C we know is 3 by 5, right? Correct. So we directly get the answer here. And this answer comes out to be 84 by 5. Right? Very simple. In general, using sine and cosine rule, you should be able to find many of these results. All of these results are there in chapter number 12 of SLONE. Okay. So you should be able to prove many things there. So for example, one last question we can say is this one. For any triangle, if tan A by 2 is equal to 5 by 6 and tan b by 2 is equal to 20 by 37. Okay, find tan c by 2 and also prove that in this triangle, we have a plus c is equal to 2b. Okay. This is not as obvious as the previous things that we have seen, but still it is fairly easy. First thing that you need to realize here, is anyone having any idea what to do, how to do it?
I think, sir, tan of a plus b by 2, by formula tan a plus tan b upon 1 minus tan a tan b.
If you say this is equal to tan a by 2 plus tan b by 2 by 1 minus tan a by 2, tan b by 2, right?
Yes, and putting the values.
You can put the values here and you can know that this is actually going to be 90 minus c by 2, right?
Yes.
So basically, first thing to know is that formula tan a plus b. So this is the formula for tan a plus b, which is tan a plus tan b by 1 minus tan a tan b. And instead of a and b, we are using a by 2 and b by 2 here. And because it is a triangle, a plus b plus c is equal to 180 degrees. Therefore, a by 2 plus b by 2 plus c by 2 will be equal to 90 degrees, right?
Yes, sir.
So a by 2 plus b by 2 can be written as 90 minus c by 2. And this becomes cot c by 2. So cot c by 2 is coming out to be 5 by 6 plus 20 by 37 by 1 minus 5 by 6 multiplied by 20 by 37, right? So this is going to become 5 into 37, which is 185, plus 20 into 6, 120, divided by 6 into 37 will cancel. This is 6 into 37, 185 plus 37. So 222 minus 100, right? So this becomes 305 by 122, right? So this is equal to 61 into 5, 61 into 2. So this is 5 by 2, right? Correct?
Yes, sir.
So you get cot c by 2 is 5 by 2. Therefore, tan c by 2 is equal to 2 by 5. So we get tan c by 2 as 2 by 5. And now we have to prove that in this triangle, this is happening, okay? So all the individual tan A by 2, tan B by 2, and tan C by 2, we know, right? So in order to prove this, what I will do is first derive a result. So we'll derive a result where we say, what is sine A by 2? What is cos a by 2 and what is tan a by 2 in terms of the sides? Okay. So if you remember, cos A is equal to B square plus C square minus A square by 2BC, right? By cosine rule. So what we can do here is write cos A using the double angle formula. Cos A is equal to 2 cos square A by 2 minus 1. Has everyone seen this formula before?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So this is double angle formula. It can also be written as 1 minus 2 sine square A by 2, right?
Yes.
We are using the property that sine square A by 2 plus cos square A by 2 is equal to 1.
What? Yes.
So if you write this like this, then we can say that 2 cos square A by 2 is equal to 1 plus cos A, right? So if I say 1 plus cos A, it will be equal to 1 plus B square plus C square minus A square by 2BC, which will become B square plus C square minus A square plus 2BC by 2BC, which will become B plus C whole square minus A square by 2BC, right? Correct. So this is 2 cos square A by 2. 2 cos square A by 2 is becoming B plus C plus A multiplied by B plus C minus A by 2BC. Is everyone understanding how I am using the formula A square minus B square is equal to A plus B into A minus B here?
Yes,
sir. Oh, yes, sir.
So we are getting cos square A by 2 is equal to B plus C plus A multiplied by B plus C minus A divided by 4BC. Right? Once we get this, what we can say is in a triangle, you would have heard of in 9th and 10th grade, you would have seen Heron's formula for area of a triangle, right?
So yes, sir.
Heron's formula, area of the triangle comes out as this, where your S is the semi-perimeter. So 2S is equal to perimeter, right? So now you will say here, this part can be written as 2S because this is A plus B plus C. And this part can be written as 2s minus 2a, which will be b plus c plus a minus 2a. So minus a, right? So you'll write this as 2s multiplied by 2s minus 2a divided by 4bc. And that gives you cos square a by 2 is coming out to be s minus a by bc, right? 2 and 2 got cancelled with the 4 down there, right? Correct.
Yes.
So we have gotten a good formula for cos A by 2, which is equal to root over S minus A by BC. How did we get it? We got it by using double angle formula for cos A and wrote it using 2 cos square A by 2 and then used cosine rule. Make sense, this formula?
Yes, sir.
And similarly, we can get another formula for sine A by 2 also. Sine A by 2 will come out to be S minus B, S minus C by BC. Basically, again, the same thing, but cos A now you will write as 1 minus 2 sine square A by 2. And you will say 2 sine square A by 2 is equal to 1 minus B square plus C square minus A square by 2BC, right?
Yes, sir.
And then simplify, you will get this. So we have cos A by 2 is this. Cos A by 2 had come as S into S minus A by BC. And therefore tan A by 2 is coming out to be root over S minus B, S minus C by S into S minus A, right? So these three formulas are available to us because we divided sin A by 2 and cos A by 2 here. So now, in the problem that we have to prove that A plus C is equal to 2B. So let's see what we can do about this. This is supposed to be proved. So instead of A plus C, we can write 2R sine A plus 2R sine C, right? Correct.
Sine rule. Yes.
Sine rule. So A by sine A is 2R. So A is 2R sine A. So you can take 2R common, then this becomes sine A plus sine C, which is 2 sine A plus C by 2 cos A minus C by 2, right? Right?
Yes.
And that is becoming, this part is 2R into 2 sine. This is A plus C by 2, which is 90 minus B by 2. So sine 90 minus B by 2 will become actually a cos B by 2, right? So this will become a 2 cos B by 2, and this will be cos A by 2 minus C by 2. Correct?
Yes.
Okay. In the problem itself, we had found our three things were given to us, right? Tan A by 2, tan B by 2, and we had found tan C by 2 also, 2 by 5, right? Correct. So basically, we know what is the value of your tan A by 2. Tan A by 2 was 5 by 6. Tan B by 2 was 20 by 37. And tan C by 2 was 2 by 5, right? So if I know tan B by 2, can you find cos B by 2 from here?
Yes, sir.
It is possible to find, because you can do 1 plus tan square B by 2 is equal to secant square B by 2, right? So you have cos square B by 2 will be equal to 1 by 1 plus tan square B by 2, right? Correct?
Yes.
So what we can say is you will get an expression. It will be long, but it will be doable. What you can do is you will get 4R into cos B by 2 cos A minus C by 2. So this is becoming cos B by 2 is becoming 1 by root over 1 plus tan square B by 2. And cos A minus C by 2. Cos A minus C by 2, you can use the formula. It is cos A by 2 cos C by 2 plus sine A by 2 sine C by 2. So this is becoming very long though. Like, there will be a nicer way to do this. Let's think of something nicer. This is obviously very long, so I have to think of something smarter by which we can prove this. So try to think, is there any easier way? Obviously, we can put in all the values and we can find out R also and stuff. So this method will work, but it will be very long. Okay. So let's think of something better. Tan C by 2 is just 2 by 5. So okay, let's try to use the identity. Is there any smaller way? Is what I'm thinking. We had that identity earlier, right? We had one identity, tan. We have proved this basically, tan B minus C by 2 by tan B plus C by 2 is equal to B minus C by B plus C. We proved this in the question number 2 of the second question that we had done. We had done it in terms of A minus B by A plus B. Remember?
Yes, sir.
So can we multiply tan A by 2 into mm-hmm. tan C by 2?
That will help us out.
And using this the formula that you have just derived.
Which formula?
You.
The SS minus A formula.
Yes, sir. Yes.
tan A by 2 is root over S, S minus, no, it will be S minus B, S minus C by S, S minus A. S, S minus A. And tan C by 2 will be S minus C, A, S minus B by S, S minus C. If you multiply, what will happen? Tan A by 2, tan C by 2 will
is become given 5 by 6 into 2 by 5.
So what is coming this side? This side is coming, S minus A will cancel, S minus B will not cancel, S minus C will cancel. You will get S minus B whole square by S square, right? Correct.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You'll get S minus B by S, and this side is coming 2 by 5 into
5 by 6.
Okay. So this is convenient. So this becomes this. So you know now that it is 1 minus B by S is equal to 1 by 3. So B by S is equal to 2 by 3. Okay. Now it is done. So B, 3B is equal to 2S, right?
Yes, sir.
2S is A plus B plus C. Right, so you will get A plus C is equal to 2B.
Yes, sir.
So okay, so this is the right way. This is fastest. Nothing else will be as fast. We have to use these two formulas. Tan A by 2 we have just derived. Tan C by 2 we have just derived. The values of A by 2 and C by 2 were simple. 2 by 5 and 5 by 6. Multiplying them gave us this nice result, S minus B by S, right?
Yes. And
from there, we were able to find B and S relationship. We got this, right? So this gives us A plus C is equal to 2B. So what I want you guys to do now is practice questions from chapter 12, exercise 27, okay? Exercise 27 in SL only. So if you do exercise 27 in SL only, this is in chapter 12, you will get a sense of all of these sine rule, cosine rule formulas. And you
all the questions.
Not all the questions, do as much as you can. I'm just telling you that through this exercise, you will be able to revise basically all the sine rule, cosine rule stuff. And all the formulas you will be able to remember. What I will do now is go on to chapter 15. And in chapter 15, there are basically four things that we need to learn. Four types of triangle centers. So we will start out with orthocenter. And then incenter and excenter. And then centroid. And circumcenter. So everyone knows what these terms are. What is the meaning of these terms?
Yes, sir.
What is orthocenter?
Intersection point of the altitudes.
So intersection point of the altitudes. Altitudes are what? They are perpendiculars from vertices
to the opposite side.
Incenter will be intersection point of what?
Angle bisectors.
Internal angle bisectors. And excenter will be
external angle bisectors.
One internal and two external.
Yes.
Right? One internal angle bisector and two external angle bisectors will intersect at the excenter. Right?
Yes.
Correct, no? Centroid is what?
Medians
means what? From vertex
to opposite side.
To opposite midpoint, right? Correct. And circumcenter is basically, we have already seen, perpendicular
bisectors
will meet. So what I want you guys to know is that, like, don't get confused between any of these four points. These four points are your most important points in a triangle, right? Know the definitions properly, and we will study this in greater detail. So we'll start off with orthocenter, and chapter 15 is about understanding these four points and their relationships. So So it is very important, this chapter. So we'll start off with orthocenter A, B, C. And if I want to draw the orthocenter, what I have to do is draw up an altitude, right? And another altitude, correct? So this is 90, this is 90, right? And third altitude will also pass through this point. Later we will see a proof of this fact, proof that all three altitudes are concurrent. That is basically, we'll see it from Seva's theorem. But right now we are assuming that all the three altitudes are concurrent, okay? So this is D, this is E, and this is F. Now in this figure, your point of intersection here becomes H, and H is the orthocenter, right? In this figure, can everyone, like, you should be able to find all the angles. Any angle that you can think of in this figure, you should be able to find. So can someone tell me what is this angle? By finding all the angles, I mean in terms of A, B, and C. In terms of that. Can someone say what is this much, this angle? In terms of A, B, and C?
90 minus B.
Yeah, it is 90 minus B, obviously, because it is part of this right angle triangle here, right? And this angle was B, right? Is everyone understanding it is 90 minus B?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, someone tell me this angle, how much is this?
90 minus C.
And what is this?
90 minus A.
So basically, you're getting the sense that all the angles you can find, right? What is this angle?
C.
Correct. Because this is 90 minus C, so this is C, right? What is this angle?
A.
A. So every angle you will be able to find, no, in this figure.
Yes.
I am going to rub off all the angles with the knowledge that we can find out all the angles. Now, all the lengths, what we need to do is find all the lengths. So by all the lengths, I mean in terms of small a, small b, and small c. Okay. So some of these lengths are not so easy. For example, the length AH and HD. Those lengths will be slightly more difficult, not difficult actually, but harder, not obvious directly. But at least BD is obvious. Because this is C, by the way. This is C, this is B, right? And this much is A, right? Now tell me BD, how much is BD?
C
cos B, correct?
Yes, sir.
What is CD?
A minus C cos
B.
Or B cos C?
Yes.
Right? Yes.
And similarly, you can write this much also, AE also. And EC also, AE will become C cos A, right? Right. And EC will become how much? A cos C. Tell me if you're understanding this too.
Yes, sir.
Right? Same way. Like basically, you can find all the small partial lengths on the sides, right? On BD, CD, all of those things you can find, correct?
Yes.
Okay, so now let's focus our attention on the triangle HBD, okay? HBD. So I will draw a partial triangle like this, HBD. We know this angle was how much? Tell me this angle. 90 minus C, 90 right?
C.
Okay, so this angle is 90 minus C. We know this is known as C cos B, right? And this is 90, right? Correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then can we find AH? AH here. Not AH, I'm saying BH, right? Can we find BH easily here?
Yes, sir, using cos B.
You're using cos of angle B, right? Cos of angle B, angle B is actually 90 minus C, right?
There is sine B, sine C.
Cos of 90 minus C will be equal to BD by BH, right?
Yes.
So therefore, BH is equal to BD by cos of 90 minus C, right?
Yes, sir.
So it becomes what? BH is becoming BD is equal to C cos B divided by cos of 90 minus C is sine C, right? Correct?
Yes, sir.
What is C by sine C in a triangle?
2R,
right?
2R, sine root, yes.
So you will say BH is equal to 2R cos B.
Yes, sir.
So now, yes, we have found, now we have found this length also. This length is coming out to be 2R cos B. In the exact same manner, I could have found AH also, by the way. AH also, I would have taken triangle AFH, okay?
Yes, sir.
AFH is also 90 degree triangle. No, same way we can find AH also. You will realize, you can find it yourself. AH will become 2R cos A. And CH will become 2R cos C. I want you guys to verify this. You can check it yourself. So basically, what we are getting is BH, AH and CH are equal to 2R cos B, 2R cos A and 2R cos C. Okay. What is special about these distances? These distances are distance of the ortho center from the vertex, right?
Yes.
So BH is distance of ortho center H from the vertex B, and that came out as 2R cos B. AH is distance of ortho center from vertex A, and that is 2R cos A. So it's very easy formula to remember, right?
Yes.
We just need to know that distance of ortho center from the vertex will be 2R cos of whichever vertex it is. Correct? Make sense?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now find HD in this triangle. HD is distance of ortho center from the side. Now you know an extra side. No, BH you know is 2R cos B, right? So it is very easy to find HD now.
2R cos B cos C.
We can do sine of angle B, which is sine 90 minus C, is equal to HD by BH, right? So therefore, HD is equal to 2R cos B multiplied by sine 90 minus C is cos C, right? Correct?
Yes, sir.
So we have gotten HD is equal to 2R cos B cos C. I will draw the figure again here. And what I'm saying is, if I have ortho center somewhere here, ortho center, let's say, is H, A, B, C. We have just now found HB, HA, and HC. HA, HB, HC came as 2R cos A, cos B, cos C, right?
Yes, sir.
Which was distance of ortho center to the vertex. Now we are saying we also know how to find HD, HE, and HF. HD, HE, HF are distance of ortho center from the sides, correct?
Yes,
HD was the distance of ortho center to the side BC, right? And the formula for HD we just now derived came as 2R cos B cos C. And in triangles, you will notice that there is a lot of symmetry. Like, there is nothing special about B and C. We could have labeled it as A and B also, right?
Yes, sir.
So then you would have gotten HD is the distance to A and B. You should have gotten, let's see, HE or HF. HF should have become 2R cos A cos B. And this should be 2R cos B cos 2R cos C cos A. Do you understand what I'm saying? I'm saying that distance to the side will be equal to 2r cos of those sides. If BC was the side, it is cos B cos C. If AC was the side, it was cos C cos A. And if AB is the side, it is cos A cos B. Right? Why? Because the formulas for a triangle will be symmetric. There is nothing special about B and C that we had labeled here. It could have been labeled AB, right? In that case, it should have been 2r cos A cos B, right?
Right.
Is it making sense? Otherwise, you can prove it also. You can just do it in triangle ECH and find out HE, right? This is also right angle triangle. By the same methods, by doing 90 degree and taking angles and all, you can find the HE length. You will realize that HE length will come out to be 2r cos A cos C. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So basically, we will be able to find in this figure that we have drawn, which includes the ortho center and the foot of the perpendiculars from all the vertices to the opposite sides. Basically, it has the points A, B, C, D, E, F, and H. In that figure, you should be able to find all the side lengths and all the angles. Okay. Basically, we know everything. We know everything, every length here, every angle here. Now, if you know every length, every angle, then basically you know everything about any possible triangle in this figure, right?
Yes, sir.
What we will do in the next class is we will look at what cyclic quadrilaterals are present in this figure. Cyclic quadrilaterals in this figure, in the figure and properties of the orthic triangle. Orthic or pedal triangle that we can form in this figure. So what I want you guys to do before the next class is go through chapter 15 as much as you can. Like maybe some parts will be difficult for you to understand, but just try to read through it. Okay. If you have not done already, read through chapter 15. If you come prepared and if you have read through everything, then it will take me just one class to finish it. Otherwise, if you don't know stuff, that it might take a little more time. But we need to finish it fast. So we need to finish it in the next class only. So I want you guys to read through chapter 15 of SLONE as much as possible and come prepared. Okay. Has anybody read it already?
Yes, sir. I read it.
Have you read through all the sections? Have you understood?
Some part I was a bit confused, but most of it I understood.
Okay, so just read it again. Everyone else, whoever has not read it, please read through it. I will try, if anybody hasn't got SLONE, I will try and find a PDF and send on the group. But
I have the PDF.
So share it on the group if you have a PDF. Some people might not have it. But you should have SLONE physical copy with you because it is very useful. It's not just for Olympiads, for JEE also. Okay. Next class will probably be on Tuesday or Wednesday. I will let you know. Okay. And we have to do 3 classes in the week. So if I do the class on Wednesday, then I will have to do a class on Thursday, Friday, and Saturday probably. Out of those 3 days, another 2 classes. So yeah, I'll tell you, but just work on SLONE 12th chapter and 15th chapter. Make sure that we can finish chapter 15 by the next class. That is our target. If we can do that, then we will be fine. And then we can work on the other parts of geometry in the future classes. Okay, that's all from my side for today. We'll discuss on Tuesday or Wednesday, next class. Okay.
Sir.
Sir,
I was going through chapter 12 and there it mentioned this statement for any triangle, AB square equals to BC square plus CA square plus 2BC into CD.
AB square.
Yes, sir.
Is equal to?
BC square. Plus CA square plus 2BC into CD.
Minus 2BC.
No, it was given plus. It is given plus.
Which page? Where is it?
Sir, in my book, it is 143. For obtuse, it is given.
For obtuse?
Yes, sir.
What is the article number? There will be some article number, right?
164.
The article number is
70,
above 72.
Article number 164, I think, right?
Yes, sir. ART 72 and point is 164.
Yeah, so you can see the figure, no? See the figure. He is trying to explain cosine rule only, actually. But he is taking two separate cases. Can you see that there is a figure with three triangles on the beginning?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Obtuse, right, and acute.
So one is a acute angle, then one is a obtuse angle, one is a right angle, right? So he is saying, let the angle C be acute. Angle C is acute in the first figure. Yeah. By geometry, yes, we have this. Basically, he is doing Pythagoras theorem. He is dropping a perpendicular D, right? And he is saying, what will be AB square? AB square will be BD square plus AD square, right?
Yes, sir.
And AD square will be what? AD square will be AC square minus CD square, right?
Yes, sir.
So
we can prove it like that. Okay.
Yeah, yeah. So you will say AB square is equal to BD square plus AD square. And AD square will be, AD square AC can be written as AC square minus BC square. So now you will combine, you will keep AC square as it is, and you will do BD square minus BC square, which will be BD plus BC into BD minus BC, right?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
BD minus BC. BD minus BC is CD, right? Minus CD?
Yes, sir.
Right. And BD plus BC is what? BC.
Yes.
So what are you getting? You're getting something like what you need, no?
AC minus BC square. CD. Yes, sir.
AC square
plus BC square.
No, where is BC?
Sir, BD plus BC. How you call BC?
BD plus BC is not BC. Oh, huh. That is a mistake. Now just write it as C. You can write BC as BD plus CD. No,
yes, sir.
BC plus BD into minus CD. And now write BC as BD plus CD. So it is 2BD plus CD, right?
Yes, sir.
And now multiplied by minus CD. Now it is coming. No, minus CD square is coming. And 2BD CD is coming. Okay. Yes. I have made it is not coming exact same thing. But instead of replacing for that, you replace for the other one, right? What I'm saying is, instead of BC plus BD, write it as BC plus BD. So we wrote for BC, right? We wrote BC is this. We write
BD. Can write BC minus BD.
BC plus BC minus CD, right?
Yes, sir.
Then it will be 2BC minus CD. Now it will come. Right, you will get 2BC into CD and CD square will come, right?
Right.
Basically, all three cases are different versions of Pythagoras theorem, okay?
So,
just see the right angle triangle that he has drawn and just write the right angle triangle Pythagoras theorem accordingly, right?
Okay, sir.
You will be able to prove it. But you don't need to worry about it so much. What you need in this section is just the sine rule, cosine rule, and stuff that we have discussed.
Okay.
Read through chapter 15 also, and we'll discuss in the next class. Okay. That's all for now. I'll see you guys. The recording will be posted on the website. I will post the recording in our website by tomorrow for sure. So you can watch it there also. Later, if you have any doubts. Okay. Okay. Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Bye. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Bye, sir. Good night.